incredibly potent yet often overlooked aspect of magical practice is drama, theater, atmosphere, ambiance. Particularly when communicating with spirits or practicing extensive ritual work. Now, I'm not saying it's entirely necessary. You can do this anywhere. You can do this with the most minimal of resources. You can do it with no resources. You can do it with just yourself, and it works fine. But there is something to be said of psychodrama, of theater. It's a tradition as old as time. It brings us into a state of awareness. It brings us to that in-between place. It's like lubricant for the energy. Even from a psychological standpoint, let's put it this way. If I was trying to convince myself that I was a soldier, if I had militant surroundings, daily regiments, and only engaged in things that presented in such a way, well, I'd be much more likely to convince myself that I was a soldier rather than if I was sleeping in, playing video games, and wearing normal clothes. Maybe that's a bad example, but it works. You want your space to come to life. You want your tools to have life, the wand, the dagger, the pentagram, the chalice. You know, have a change of clothes for magic, wear a gown. You know, it may sound a bit silly, but I assure you, if you do this, if you sanctify a sacred place in your home that is dedicated to only magical or sacred objects, and that you go to for that one purpose of communicating with the divine, it unlocks something in your mind that helps bring you there. Visualization and magic is inherently creative. I mean, it is the creative essence within us. It is the expression of God through us. So I'm of the opinion, the more creative you are with it, the better. After all, what zest is there in life without art? And magical practice is very much a science and an art.